So in this video, I want to talk briefly about the notation of inverses and reciprocals. This notation can often be a little confusing. Understandably, inverses and reciprocals both use the same symbol, this negative one symbol, but the placement of that symbol in the context is important in determining whether it's talking about an inverse or a reciprocal. So, for example, we're going to think about notation like this versus this notation, and so on. Okay, so basically I just have created a little table over here to show you the differences and how the notation is used in each case. So let's start with this first point here. So f to the negative 1 of x is the notation used to represent the inverse function of f of x. This is just the convention. So if you see the negative 1 power up there, you know, right after the f negative 1 of x, that always just represents the inverse function of x. On the other hand, if the notation looks like this instead, the entire function f of x to the negative 1, this by convention means f of x raised to the negative 1 power. And that does mean the reciprocal, 1 over f of x. So really just the placement of the negative 1 symbol is what determines whether you're talking about the inverse or the reciprocal in this case. So just make sure you study and remember those differences so you can read and both write the math correctly. Now, in this section right here that I've written, when you're just dealing with a variable by itself or just dealing with a number by itself, the negative 1 is always just going to represent the reciprocal. It's only when you're thinking about functions that there's that little bit of ambivalence you have to figure out. But if you're just dealing with variables like x to the negative 1, oh, well, that's 1 over x. That's just the reciprocal. Or 3/4 to the negative 1. Well, that's just the reciprocal, 4/3. So that's kind of a simpler situation. You don't have to worry about inverses in that case because the inverse doesn't make sense. It's the reciprocal. Another function that you want to be careful with notation about, so of course we have general functions, f of x and f inverse x, but inverse trig functions are a specific type of inverse function that you want to watch out for. So it works the same way here as well. So sine negative 1 of x represents, by convention, the inverse sine function. But then if you've got the sine x, the quantity sine x to the negative 1, that represents sine x to the negative 1 power, which is the reciprocal, 1 over sine x, which has its own identity, the cosecant x. So just make sure you understand those differences in notation conventions and that you use them when applicable. And there's one more thing I should note also. You'll see the inverse sine function or any inverse trig function often written in a different way. So sine negative 1x, that's the inverse sine function, can also be written as the arcsine of x, or for example, like the inverse tangent, tan negative 1x can be written as the arc tan of x. And this notation is pretty nice, really, because it avoids that ambivalence with the negative 1 notation. So just realize that you'll see these used interchangeably, and you're welcome to use either notation in your own work.